Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So now continuing class 10th pair of linear equations in two variables, exercise 3.2, question number 4. So in till previous session I used to explain you by typing the answers and I was explaining you, but I thought of writing instantly and explaining you. It will be better to make you understand easily. So now question number 4, if you see the question number 4, which of the following pairs of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent? If it is consistent, if consistent, obtain the solution graphically. Okay, this is the question. So before solving this question, let you all clear about the statement consistent and inconsistent. What are the meaning of consistent and inconsistent? So as we discussed earlier, we have three types of lines, right? As you all know, the general form of linear equation, if I consider general form of linear equation, the general form is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So these are the two linear equation, the general form of linear equation. Okay, here if we plot the graph for linear equation, we have, if we consider one equation, we have one straight line. Okay, if we plot another equation, we will get another straight line. But these two straight lines may be of three types. Number one, it can be intersecting. Intersecting means this is one line, another line may be like this, and they're intersecting at one point. Okay, if it is intersecting, we say that it has only one solution, means one value which satisfies the given equation. Okay, then the second case is parallel. That means the two lines will be parallel to each other. Like this, if it is parallel to each other, there is no common points between them, so we don't have any solution, so you can write no solution. Okay, then coincident means all the points are similar, one line will be come above the other, so one will be above the other, they coincide each other. Okay, so we have many solution. Okay, for intersecting we have only one solution, for parallel we have no solution, for coincident we have many solution. Okay, so we learnt about this, and by observing the equation we can say whether, this is how we can say that by plotting on the graph, if it comes intersecting we say one solution, right? If they are parallel we say no solution, if they are coincident we say many solution. But without plotting the graph, by observing the equation, we can say whether they are parallel, whether they are coincident, or whether they are intersecting. How? Means we have three conditions. We have three conditions depending upon the coefficient. Which are the coefficient? A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. So these are the coefficient. By the condition related to these coefficient, we can say that whether they are consistent or inconsistent. Okay, so which are those condition? If we come to the first condition, we have A1 by A2. We will take the ratio of the coefficients. Okay, we'll take the ratio of the coefficient A1 by A2, which is not equal to B1 by B2. Okay, for example, if it is 1 by 2, for example, 1 by 2 is not equal to 1 by 3. For example, if I get like this, so A1 is 1, A2 is 2, B1 is 1, B2 is 2, like this, it is not equal. So at this case, these are intersecting lines, intersecting. If A1 is not equal to B1 by B2, A1 by A2, so it is intersecting lines. As I told you, if intersecting lines, we have one solution. At least remember, if you are getting at least one solution, it is called as consistent. Consistent, we are calling it as consistent. Okay, then if you go for second condition, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. Okay, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. Okay, so here the first itself is not equal. Okay, at that case we are calling it as intersecting. We have one solution. At least you are getting one solution. It is consistent. Okay, then if you come for second solution, now A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. Okay, the ratios. So at this case, the equations are parallel. Again, I am explaining. Observe carefully, listen carefully. This is very, very important, because related to these conditions, you will get definitely every year they are going to ask one MCQ question. So listen carefully. Okay, so they're parallel. So you don't have any solution, no solution. Okay, no solution. If you are not getting any solution, it is inconsistent. If it is inconsistent, okay, clear. So now last one. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. All are equal now. All are equal. The coefficients are equal. At this case, as I told you, it is coincident. Coincident lines. They are coincident lines. Means it is one above the other. So you have many solutions. Many solutions. Means the points will be similar. Okay, so at this case, as I told you, if you get at least one solution, it is consistent. Here you have getting many solution, it is also consistent. Okay, clear. So you have three relations. How you are going to take the coefficient of the linear equations, and you are taking the ratios A1 by A2, which is not equal to B1 by B2. It is intersecting. It has one solution. If it is, you are getting at least one solution, it is also consistent. Okay. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. They are parallel lines. So you don't have any solution. It is inconsistent. Clear? The last case, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. All are equal. They are coincident. You have many solution, and that is also consistent. That means, which are the consistent case here? Intersecting and coincident are consistent. Parallel is inconsistent. This is how you have to remember the cases. Okay. Now, using this, we are going to solve question number. First question is x plus y is equal to 5. 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. Okay, now what is the general formula for a linear equation? Which is a linear equation we are having? So let us write the general form. So a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Okay, this is the general form. Here observe, in general form it is equal to 0, but here it is equal to 5, equal to 10. So we have to make it equal to 0. So take both constant to the LHS, okay. So now let us change this. So it becomes x plus y, if it come to the LHS, it becomes minus 5 is equal to 0. Okay, now this also, 2x plus 2y, if you come this side, it becomes minus 10 is equal to 0. Okay, now let us write which is A1, which is A2, which is B1, which is B2, which is C1, which is C2. Okay, if we compare these two, you can compare xx you have. If nothing is there, you have to consider it as 1. So what is A1 here? A1 is 1. Okay, next, yy you have. But B1 also you have 1 only. So B1 is equal to 1. Okay, this is very simple. If you understand this, this is very simple problems you can solve easily. So in the place of C1, what you have? C1 you have minus 5. Okay, next let's compare these two. A2x, 2x. So in the place of A2 you have 2. In the place of B2 you have 2. In the place of C2, you have minus 10. Observe, minus 10 including sign you have to consider. Okay. Now, what is our condition? We have to check their coefficient, right? We have to check their coefficient. So, let us check this coefficients. So, A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Okay, let us observe. 1 by 2. So, A1 is 1, A2 is 2. So, 1 by 2. Again, B1 is 1. B2 is 2. Okay, then C1 is minus 5, C2 is minus 10. So if we cancel this, minus minus cancel, 5 ones are 5 twos. Again, you are getting 2. So that means all are equal, right? So look here, A1 by A2 is 1. B1 by B2 is 1 by 2. C1 by C2 is 1 by 2. All are equal. So in this case, what we can write? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So at this case, the type of linear equation are? The lines are, therefore, lines are, which are these? Coincident, right? If all are equal, what we can write? Coincident. So you have how many solution? So lines are coincident. So many solution. And these are, what we can write? These are consistent or inconsistent? You are getting many solutions. So it is consistent. Okay. So first, what you have to write? You first write the general equation. Convert the given equation into general equation by taking constant to the LHS. But RHS should be equal to 0. That you have to observe. And by observing and comparing with the general, write A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. Write the coefficient A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Here you are getting all are equal, right? 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. So what is our condition? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So lines are coincident. You have many solution. So if you are getting many solution, these are consistent. Clear? So if it is consistent, what is the question given? If it is consistent, obtain solution graphically. So if it is consistent, you have to solve this graphically. So we have to solve this graphically. So using graph sheet. Okay, let us find the points. First, before solving graphically, we have to find the points. So as I told you, the first step is you have to convert the equation in terms of y. So you want y means send x to the RHS. So it becomes y is equal to, it becomes 5 minus x, right? Then here also you have to convert in terms of y. So to keep 2y as it is, take 2x to the RHS, 10 minus 2x, right? So you want the value of y. So it is multiplied. So if compute, it becomes division. Y is equal to 10 minus 2x by 2. Okay, you got two equation in terms of y. So let us take the values. So let's take the table, two table. And when you're solving graphically, the table is must. You can take only two values. It's enough. So values. So one is x, another one is y. Now give the values for x, you will get the values of y. Okay. So first let us take the value as 0. So if x is 0. So now if x is 0, what happens? Now if I take y is equal to 5 minus 0, what it happens is 5. So y is equal to, you got 5. So y is 5 now. Okay, so you can take any value. Now if I give 1, so y as x as 1 now, in the place of x, if I give 1, so what happens? Y is equal to 5 minus 1. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So if you give 1, value will be 4. Now you got two values, it's enough. So now let's go for here now. So what is x now? So if you give 0 here, the same thing, 0, if I give 0, so what happens here? 0, if you give 2 zeros, so let's see, y is equal to 10 minus 2 into 0 by 2. So 2 zeros are 0. So 10 minus 0, so 10 by 2. What you will get? 10 by 2, 5. 5 you got. Again, what is the value? If I give 1, the same thing, if I give 1 here, so y is equal to 10 minus 2 into 1 by 2, right? So 10 minus 2 ones are 2 by 2. So 10 minus 2, it is 8. 8 by 2. 8 by 2, you got 4. So see here. See the points now. 0, 5, 1, 4. Why you are getting the same values? Because they're coincident. The many solution means you have many common points. So 0, 5, 1, 4. So let's plot the graph. So now, which is our first point? 0, 5, right? If you take 0, the value means x is 0, y is 5. Means x is 0, y is 5 means this is one point, right? This is one point, which is this point 0, 5. The same for both the lines, right? Next, which is our another point? 1, 4. So x is 1, y is 4. So you got here, okay? The same points for both the lines. So let's draw the line. So if we draw the line for both, so draw it for both the lines. So it is 1, 4. So for both the lines, write like this. For both the lines, the points are same here. 0, 5, 1, 4 for both the lines. So which are the both the lines? One is x is equal to 5. The another line is 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. So you have to write everything and you have to mention the scale also. You can observe here we took 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like this scale x axis, and as I told you, 1, 1 box measures 1, 1 centimeter. Okay, so I took 1, 1 box, so it is 1 centimeter. How many units? 1 unit. So y axis also 1, 1 box, so 1 centimeter, 1 unit. And here both the lines are coincident, so you're getting one above the other. Okay, so this is about sub question 1. In sub question, here x minus y is equal to 8, 3x minus 3y is equal to 16. I'll go faster, little bit faster. So as I told you, first write the general equation: a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Now change this given equation into general equation, that is x minus y, take a to the LHS, minus 8 is equal to 0. Okay, why? Because the RHS should be 0. This is the one of the hint you have to observe. Next, 3x minus 3y minus 16 is equal to 0. Okay, minus 16 is equal to 0. Now let us compare with the coefficients, given coefficient. So what is the given coefficient? So here what you can write, a1 is equal to, what is the a1 here? 1. What is b1? You can observe b1 is minus 1. B1 is minus 1. What is c1? Minus 8. Okay, minus 8. Again, if you compare here also, what is a2? If you compare a2, it is 3. B2, it is minus 3. C2, it is minus 16. Minus 16. So what is our ratios? A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Let us compare. A1 by A2 means 1 by 3. Okay. Next, B1. Minus 1 by minus 3. Again, minus minus cancel. 1 by 3 only. Again, minus 8 by 16. Minus 16. Minus minus cancel. 1s are, 2s are. How you got? If you compare this, here you are getting 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 2. So here you are getting 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 2. Here if you compare the relation, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. Right? Both are equal but not equal to C1 by C2. C1 by C2. That means here therefore lines are parallel. Parallel. So no solution. No solution. No solution. Therefore it is inconsistent. Okay, inconsistent. So if it is inconsistent, you no need to solve graphically, you can stop here. Okay, 3. So here also it is already in a general form, you no need to look here. We have RHS is equal to 0, you no need to change into general form. Just let us write the general equation. What is our general equation? A1x B1y plus C1 is equal to 0, A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. Okay, so let us write. What is A1 now? A1 it is 2. B1 it is 1. C1 is equal to minus 6. Just to check it. A1 2. B1 it is 1. If it is nothing, you have to consider it as 1. C1 it is minus 6. Here also A2 it is 4. B2 it is minus 2. C2 it is minus 4. Okay, let us write here. A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Let us find out 2 by 4. You are getting 2 by 4. If you simplify it, 1 by 2. Again, 1 by minus 2. 1 by minus 2. Here, minus 6 by minus 4. Minus, minus, cancel. 3, 2. So, if you check here, 1 by 2 you are getting. 1 by minus 2, 3 by 2. Okay, if you observe these two, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, right? A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Okay, the first itself is they're not equal. What does it mean? Therefore, lines are intersecting. So first itself, it is not equal. They're intersecting. You have Therefore, one solution, you can write one solution. It is consistent, because if you are getting at least one solution, you can write it as consistent. If it is consistent, what we have to write? We have to find graphically. Okay, let's find graphically. So first equation, 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. So now we have to find the equation in terms of y. So let it be y in LHS, take RHS and this side. Now 2x and constant to the RHS. So now y is equal to y. So let us first send minus 6, it becomes. So y is equal to minus 6, it becomes plus 6. Plus 2x becomes minus 2x, right? You got the equation in terms of y. Observe, only the LHS should contain y. Send others to the RHS. So first you send constant. Minus 6 becomes plus 6. 2x, it becomes minus 2x. So y is equal to, you got equation. Again, if here, you can observe y is positive or negative. Y is positive or negative. And remember, always make y as positive. Y as positive here. So here you can observe here. Take minus 2y to the RHS. Why, ma'am, till then you said that y should be in LHS. Now why you are taking to the RHS? Because here y is negative. So if it is negative, no issues. But when you are substitution, when you are simplifying, you will be confused, and you will leave, if you leave the minus sign, the whole equation will be wrong. So instead of making that issues, better. So take y to the RHS. When you have to take y to the RHS? When it is negative. When it is negative, remember. Okay, now 4x be there only, minus 4. So minus 4 is also negative. Take minus 2y to the RHS. So minus 2y it becomes plus 2y. Just you interchange, don't do anything, write like this. You write this into the this side. No, nothing changes here. Just you are writing this to the LHS, 4x minus 4 to the RHS. You are not doing anything. Just if it is negative, take y itself to the RHS. Take y itself to the RHS. It becomes positive. 4x minus 4. Just you write. Just you interchange this. No issues. Okay. Now you want the value of y. So 4x minus 4 divided by 2. 4x minus 4 divided by 2. You got two equations. Now let us take the values for both the sides. So if you take values. Okay, x, y. So first if I take 0, 2 zeros are, you can check y is equal to 6 minus 2 into 0. If I take 0, x as 0, 2 into 0, it is 0. 6 minus 0, you will get 6. So y becomes 6. Now if I take 1, so y is equal to 6 into 2 into 1. So 2 into 1, it is 2. 6 minus 2, it is 4. Okay. 4 you got value. Now let's go for here. So first if I take 0, consider x as 0 now. X is equal to 0. If I give 0, y is equal to 4 into 0 minus 4 by 2. So 4 zeros are 0. 0 minus 4, it is minus 4 by 2. So 2 1s are 2 2s are. So you got minus 2. Remember, minus 2 you got. Again, if I take 1, so y as 1, x as 1 now. Now if I take x as 1, so 4 into 1 minus 4 by 2. Now observe, 4 minus 4 by 2, 4 minus 4, 0. 0 by 2, it is 0. So 1, 0. Okay, now we are not getting the common points. You can check, ma'am, if it is intersecting, we have to get common points, right? You can, if you plot these two points, if you join those two lines, definitely you will get the common point. Take a graph. Again, as I told you, first you have to write the scale. X-axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit, because I took 1 boxes. So 1 centimeter, 1, 2, 3 like this. So 1 unit. Again, y-axis also. Which is our first point? 0, 6, 1, 4. So which is the first point? 0, 6. That means x is 0, y is 6. So we got one point, that is 0, 6, 1, 4. Next, another point is 1, 4. So here it is 1, 4. So first, if you get the first two points, draw a line for that, because if you take second point, you may confuse while joining. So let us join this line. So which is this line? The line, it is first equation, it is 2x plus y. 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. This is the first line. Okay, let's go for next point. So next point is 0 comma minus 2. 0 comma minus 2 means x is 0, y is minus 2. You will get here this point. Okay, then 1 comma 0. X is 1, y is 0. So y is 0 means this point. This is 0 comma minus 2. This point it is 1 comma 0. Okay, let's join these two points. We will get a common point where it will intersect. Okay, they are intersecting at a point that is 2 comma 2. It is intersecting at 2 comma 2. Now we can check in equation. If we check in equation, you can observe. If I take 2 now. So if I take another box, here also another box. If I take another box, if I take 2, let me check. Y is equal to 6 into 2 comma 2. Let me check here. 2 2s are 4. So 6 minus 4, you will get 2, right? 2, right? 2 you are getting. Here also, that means 2. Here also, if you observe, if I take 2, so Y is equal to 4 into 2 minus 4 by 2. 4 2s are 8. 8 minus 4 by 2. 8 minus 4, you will get 4 by 2. Again, you are getting 2. So, if you take 2, 2. So, 2 comma 2, 2 comma 2. So, if you see in the graph also, we are getting 2 comma 2 as a common point. 2 comma 2 as a common point. So, this is about sub-question 3. This is the last sub-question in this exercise. That is, here we are getting. So, let's first, what is our first step? We have to write the general equation. That is, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So let us write what is a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2. What is a1 here? 2. Okay. B1, it is minus 2. C1, minus 2. Okay. Again here, if you come for a2, it is 4. B2, it is minus 4. C2, so C2 is equal to minus 5. So what is our step? We have to find A1 by A2, B1 by B2, C1 by C2. Okay, what is A1 by A2? 2 by 4. Again, here minus 2 by minus 4. Again, here if you cancel this, 1, 2 1s are 2 2s are. Again, minus minus cancel, 2 1s are 2 2s are. Here minus 2 by minus 5, minus minus cancel. If you check the values, 1 by, you are getting, you are getting 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 by 5. 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 by 5. That means A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2, right? Look here, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 by 5. This is here, which is the condition for this? This is, that means lines are, so lines are parallel, parallel. Therefore, no solution. No solution. So it is inconsistent. It is inconsistent. You can stop here. If it is inconsistent, there is no need of plotting the graph. If it is consistent, you have to plot the graph and you have to find the points. Okay, this is about question number 4 in exercise 3.2. So if you like this video, do subscribe my channel, share with your friends, and keep watching. Thank you.